Welcome to your end of year guide. This guide is for admins who used CSV to roster this year and plan to roster with Clever or ClassLink next year. End your year in four steps. Add student IDs and merge students, archive classes, archive student accounts, then request Seesaw in Clever or ClassLink. Before we get started, make sure you're signed in to your Seesaw for Schools admin account. If you're a district admin, you'll need to complete the following steps for all schools in your district. Access each school's dashboard by tapping on the school name on your district dashboard. First, add student IDs and merge students. Student IDs keep student portfolios together from different classes and years. Each year, check to make sure all students have a student ID and merge duplicate journals to ensure students have access to historic data in one cohesive journal. On your school dashboard, under Admin Tools, tap Assign Missing Student IDs. Type in each student's student ID. If you are switching to Clever, these IDs need to be student SAS IDs in Clever. If you are switching to ClassLink, student IDs need to be the student sourced ID in ClassLink. Just make sure student IDs stay the same year over year. Pro tip, you can use the filter by class feature at the top of the screen to add student IDs by class. When adding IDs, you may see that an ID is already in use. This means there are multiple journals for the student. This can happen if a student is in multiple classes and different accounts were created for them. An option to merge will appear. Tap Click here to merge and follow the prompts to merge the two journals into one. Make sure the information is accurate. This step cannot be undone. Repeat the process for all students here. It is important to note that an email address counts as a student ID. If students have an email address but do not have a student ID, they will not appear under Assign Missing IDs. If student email addresses are in Clever or ClassLink, and they match the emails that currently exist in Seesaw, the account should update when you sync with Clever or ClassLink in the fall. Now that all students have a student ID and duplicates have been merged, bulk archive classes to ensure you have accurate analytics, and so students are able to easily toggle in and out of next year's classes instead of posting work in their previous year's class. On your school dashboard, under Admin Tools, tap Archive Old Classes. Select a date to archive classes created before that date. We recommend choosing the last day of school or the day you plan to archive classes in order to capture all of the classes that were created before that date. Tap Archive Classes and you're done. Once you archive classes, you can bulk archive student accounts. You need to first archive classes, because you won't be able to archive students if they are enrolled in an active class. Archiving student accounts will ensure you have accurate analytics and billing. On your school dashboard, under Admin Tools, tap Archive Student Accounts. Seesaw will tell you exactly how many students are going to be archived. Tap Archive Old Student Accounts to continue. Don't worry. Archiving student accounts does not automatically delete them. No data will be deleted without your knowledge. Archive students will still be in your dashboard, but they will not be taking up licenses. You can restore them at any time. Once you tap Archive Accounts, you're all done. Finally, request Seesaw in Clever or ClassLink. Sign in to your new Clever or ClassLink admin account. Clever users, click Applications, then Add Application. Search for Seesaw and follow the prompts. ClassLink users, install Roster Server. It's a different app than the SSO app. ClassLink Roster Server makes one roster format data available to Seesaw and is where you configure your sharing rules. And that's it. In four simple steps, you've set yourself up for a smooth back to school with Seesaw. At the start of next school year, you will complete all setup steps, including completing a full sync. Don't worry, we'll walk you through how to do it. Find setup steps and resources here. We recommend bookmarking this page for quick access. Thanks for joining us today. See you again soon.